Thank you for being with us. We are continuing on the teaching about how to know my breakthrough season. We bless you, mighty God. Give us a hearing, oh Lord, that can hear this word. Give us a ear that can hear this word for your glory. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. How to know your breakthrough season. Let's go in the book of John, chapter 3, verse 8. The Bible says this: the wind blows where he wishes, and you hear the sound of it, but cannot tell where it comes from and where it goes. So is everyone who is born of the Spirit. The Bible says the wind blows where it wishes, and you hear the sound of it, but cannot tell where it comes from and where it goes. So if you are really born again, the Bible is comparing you as a wind. You can hear the sound of the winds, but you can't see it. You can't tell where it's coming from and where it's going to, but you can hear the sound, the way it's blowing. So if you are really a new born again, a Christian who is really born again, you are like a wind. They can hear the sounds, how you are blowing, the sound of your blowing, how you are blown. They can hear the sound, but the people will not know where you are coming from. The only person you can know, God. And sometimes God can reveal you yourself. You yourself can know where you're coming from, and you will also know where you are going to. As a Joseph, God revealed to Joseph, I will make you a governor of Egypt. So Joseph knew he was going to elevation. So if God revealed to you where you are going to, you yourself will know. And God also will know where you came from and where you are going to. But the people around you, they will not know. They will just hear the sound of you blowing, but they will not know where you are coming from and where you are going to. If you are a really, really Christian who is born again. So I'm just talking to someone. I'm just telling someone who is really a newborn again. I'm talking to someone. I'm not talking to everybody, but I'm talking to someone. I know the person is listening to me right now, is hearing me right now. I don't know who is that, but I know I'm not talking to everybody. I know I'm talking to someone. I don't know if the person is you. I don't know if the person is you who are following me right now. I'm just telling someone, your sound is about to be heard. Your sound is about to be heard. Your blowing sound is about to be heard. Hey, the sound of a victory against a Goliath is the sound of a victory against Goliath of David. The sound of victory against Goliath is a David. I'm just telling someone, your sound of a victory is about to be heard. I'm just telling someone, the sound of you coming out of the den of the lion is a Daniel who came out of the den of the lion. The people always, when they go in the den of the lion, they will not come back alive. The lion will eat them, will crush them. But Daniel went in the den of the lion and came out. Oh, I'm just telling someone, your sound of coming out of the den of the lion is about to be heard as a Daniel, and there will be change. They are going to change the law, the rule of religion because of you. Because in the time of Daniel, they change the law, the rule of religion. Because in Babylon, there was a law, you cannot worship any other god. They were worshiping the idol, the god of the idol. But when Daniel came out of the den of the lion, the king himself, nobody told him. He said, "The things I saw, I never seen that before." Daniel came out of the den of the lion, physically normal, without anything wrong in his body. No, I have to change the law of religion. The king give order to people. We will never worship any other god except the true God of Daniel. I'm just telling someone, your sound of deliverance, your sound of healings, your sound of a promotion, your sound of a peace, your sound of elevation, your sound is about to be heard soon. Is about to be heard soon. Is about to be heard soon. I'm just telling someone, as Elizabeth, the mother of John the Baptist, your sound is about to be heard. The sound of having a baby. The sound of having a baby. As Elizabeth, they were calling her barren, but her sound was heard that she had John the Baptist, and after John, she had the other kid. I'm just telling someone, I don't know who's that, but I know I'm talking to someone. Your sound is about to be heard soon. The sound of healing, the sound of a peace, the sound of elevation, the sound of coming out from Egypt, the sound of crossing the Red Sea. As Israel, when they crossed the Red Sea, they faced the Red Sea, but they crossed the Red Sea, and their sound was heard everywhere. Jericho, the people of Jericho, they were afraid of the children of Israel because of their sound was heard. I'm telling someone, your sound to cross the Red Sea and dry ground is about to be heard soon. Is about to be heard soon. If you know it's you, if you know I'm talking to you, can you stand up and shout Jesus? Your sound is about to be heard. How to know my breakthrough season? Now, how many of us would like to be blessed? All of us like to be blessed. Therefore, you can hear the Christian, the people, when they are praying. When they are praying, they pray, "God bless me. I'm tired of this life of suffering. God bless me. God do this to me." You are doing well. Because when you are asking, God will give to you. But my question is, do you know what you are asking for? I know you are asking for blessing, that God bless you. But my question is, can you handle blessing? Can you handle breakthrough that you are asking from God? Can you handle that? It's a wonderful thing to be blessed. It's a wonderful thing to ask that God bless me. But my question is, can you handle that? A lot of people are asking what they cannot handle. Let's go in the book of Psalm chapter 23, verse 5. What does the Bible say to us? Psalm chapter 23, verse 5. The Bible says this: "You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup run over." The Bible says you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemy. You are asking God to bless you. You are doing well. You are asking a good things, because we all need to be blessed. But the question is, can you handle the blessing that you are asking God? The Bible says God prepared, before God to bless you, God will prepare the blessing that you are asking for. He will prepare a table of the blessing. But that table, God is not preparing the table in the hiding place. No. The Bible says you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. So a table is here. You are here because it's your blessing. God will prepare a table for you. When you are asking a blessing from God, He say, okay, I hear you. Let me prepare the table of that blessing. You are right here. He will prepare that right in front of you, but in the presence of your enemy. You are here and your enemy in the other side, and the table right there. So you are facing the table of your blessing, and at the same time, you are facing also your enemy. So your enemy also, they are seeing what God is preparing for you. Can you handle what you are asking God? How to know my breakthrough season? Your enemy are seeing what God is preparing for you. You know what will happen? Because they know it's not their blessing. It's in their presence. God is preparing your table in their presence. They know that blessing is now of them, is your blessing. They are seeing that. What will they have? Do you think they will like that when they are your enemies? Can you handle what you are asking God? Bear with us. Continue to watch. Listen, that is why you see the brother of Joseph, they hated Joseph, the own brother of Joseph, same blood from one father, Jacob, their own brother. I'm not talking the adopted brother, I'm talking the blood brother of Joseph. They hate their own brother. You know why? Because they did understand God was preparing a table for Joseph in their presence. That's why they ate Joseph. The Bible says in the book of Genesis, chapter 37, from verse 1 to verse 36. But because of time, if you have the Bible, you can read the verses 7 to verse 11. Let's just read that. Genesis. I'm just telling someone, God is preparing your table. Your table is getting ready. Your table is getting ready. You know the things you've been asking God. You know the things you've been in fast. You've been fasting how many days? You've been praying, crying. You know the things. But I'm just telling you, God is telling you right now, your table is getting prepared. He's preparing your table. Soon your table will get ready. Soon your table will get ready. Soon your table will get ready. But just know your table, God is preparing that in the presence of your enemy. Genesis chapter 37, verse 7 to verse 11, the Bible says this: there we were bounding sheaves in the field. Then behold, my sheaf arose, also stood upright, and indeed your sheaves stood all around and bowed down to my sheaf. And his brothers said to him, shall you indeed reign over us, or shall you indeed have dominion over us? So they hated him even more for his dream and for his word. Listen to this. So they hated the own brother of Joseph. They hated him even more for his dreams and for his word. They hate him even more. Means if they hate him before 50 degrees or 50%, even more will be like 100% or 70% or 200%. Then he dreams still another dreams and told it to his brothers and said, look, I have dreams, another dream. And this time the sun, the moon, the 11 stars bowed down to me. So he told it to his father and his brother. And his father rebuked him and said to him, what is this dream that you have dreamed? Shall your mother and I and your brothers indeed come to bow down to earth before you? 11, and his brothers envied him, but his father kept the matter in his mind. You know, his own brother hate him. Why? Because they discover, they know God is preparing a table for Joseph, a table of being elevated in their midst, a table of elevation. Therefore, they hate Joseph. But Joseph had the grace from God to handle that. My question is, you've been praying breakthrough, asking breakthrough to God. Your table is getting ready soon. God is preparing your table. But the question is, can you handle what you are asking God? Because there will be the people, when God is preparing your table in the present, they will understand that this guy has something of God. This guy has a power of God, has a calling of God in his life. This lady has a something, a gift of God. He has a promotion. He has a star. They will see that. They will understand that. The Bible says, it doesn't matter even you have their own blood. It doesn't matter even they know you. It doesn't matter if you are friend. It doesn't matter your relationship. When they understand that God is preparing a table for you, the Bible said the brother of Joseph hated Joseph. They will not encourage you. They will not encourage you to receive what God is preparing for you. Are you able to handle what you are asking for? How to know my breakthrough season? That is why I'm telling someone that as soon you discover you did nothing wrong to people, but the people stay away from you, the people run away from you, the people begin to criticize you, the people change toward you, the mind, the mentality, the world, the attitude of people change suddenly against you without you doing them wrong. They don't call you no more. They stay away from you. They begin to attack you with their word. Understand. Understand. They just discover that God is preparing your table and your table is ready. God is preparing your table in their presence like the brother of Joseph. When they will discover what they will do, they will hate. They will change toward you. But you don't get discouraged. Don't get in the mess. Don't get in the wrong attitude. Be just like Joseph for you to get what God is preparing for you. When you see in your surrounding the evil manifestation, the evil things, the evil manifestation around you, just understand God is preparing a table for you. That is your breakthrough season. So the devil trying to distract you for you to miss your table. How to know my breakthrough season? You will see the evil manifestation around you from the kingdom of darkness to steal your table, to steal your blessing. Like Joseph, he did nothing to his brother. He just see the attitude of his brother change toward him. I don't know if Joseph began to do the prayer of authority. I cast away the spirit of hatred from my brother. I cast away. But the problem was because his own brother understood that God is preparing a table for him. That is why I say, can you handle what God is preparing for you? How to know my breakthrough season? And soon you discover the people are no more happy with you. Understand God is preparing a table for you. That's your breakthrough season. Like in the time of Noah, can you imagine in all the generation, one man, Noah, found grace in the sight of God. And just Noah with his wife, his son, and his son's wife, all of them, eight people. In all generation, only eight people got saved with the animal that God sent to Noah. Why? Because the people did not understand Noah. They were away from Noah when God was preparing a table of salvation for Noah when he was building the ark. The people said, Noah, you are crazy. When you see this thing happen to you, understand that is your breakthrough season. Your breakthrough season is ready. Your table is getting ready. And your sound is about to be heard soon. Just understand that and put yourself away from any kind of miss. Put yourself away from any kind of sin. Put yourself away from any kind of things of darkness, because that's your breakthrough season. Now, how to behave in your breakthrough season? You have to behave wisely, even more wisely. Let's go in the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 18. I'm just telling someone, your breakthrough season is right there. Your table is getting ready. I'm just telling someone, God is preparing your table, and your table is getting ready. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I know I'm talking to someone. How to know my breakthrough season? 1 Samuel chapter 18, verse 14 to verse 30. Listen what the Bible says. And David behaved wisely in all his way, and the Lord was with him. Therefore, when Saul saw that he behaved very wisely, he was afraid of him. But all Israel and the Judah loved David, because he went out and came before them. Then Saul said to David, "Here is my older daughter, Merab. I will give her to you as a wife. Only be valiant for me and fight the Lord's battle." For Saul thought, "Let my hand not be against him, but let the hand of the Philistines be against him." So David said to Saul, "Who am I, and what is my life or my father's family in Israel, that I should be son-in-law to the king?" But it happened at the time when Merab, Saul's daughter, should have been given to David, that she was given to Adriel, the Meholathite, as a wife. Now, Micah, Saul's daughters, loved David, and they told Saul, and the things pleased him. So Saul said, "I will give her to him, that she might be a snare to him, and that the hand of the Philistines may be against him." Therefore, Saul said to David a second time, "You shall be my son-in-law today." And Saul commanded his servant, communicated with David secretly, and said, "Look, the king has delight in you, and all his servant loved you. Now therefore, become the king's son-in-law." So Saul's servant spoke those words in the hearing of David. And David said, "Does it seem to you a light thing to be a king's son-in-law, seeing I am a poor and lightly esteemed man?" And the servant of Saul told him, saying, "In this manner David spoke." Then Saul said, "Thus you shall say to David, the king does not desire any dowry, but 100 foreskins of the Philistines to take vengeance on the king's enemy." But Saul thought to make David fall by the hand of the Philistines. So when his servant told David this word, it pleased David well to become the king's son-in-law. Now the days had not expired. Therefore David arose and went, he and his men, and killed 200 men of the Philistines. And David brought their foreskin, and they gave them in full count to the king, that he might become the king's son-in-law. Then Saul gave him Micah, his daughter, as a wife. Thus Saul saw and knew that the Lord was with David, and that Micah, Saul's daughter, loved him. And Saul was still more afraid of David. So Saul became David's enemy continually. Then the princes of the Philistines went out to war. And so it was whenever they went out that David behaved more wisely than all the servants of Saul, so that his name highly esteemed. The word of God. Did you hear that? I cannot imagine. This is after David killed Goliath. No one was able to kill Goliath, to fight against Goliath and kill. They were afraid. But David, God used him to kill Goliath. Now, a king, Saul, ate David. Can you imagine? Your country was in danger because of your enemy, the Philistine. Goliath said, if no one will come against me, you will be in danger. If someone come against me, kill me, we're going to be your slave. If I kill a person, you're going to be my slave. So which means if no one will come, you will still be our slave. The country was in danger. The kingdom of the king Saul was in danger. God saved his kingdom through a young man, David. But what happened when the young man David killed a Philistine? The king hated him. Can you imagine that? Why? Because he understood that God was preparing a table for David to become a king. So he was trying to kill him for that not to happen. That will not happen. The Bible said David was behaving wisely, more wisely even. That is why. And the Bible also said, just when we read here, mostly in verse over here. Let me see. In verse 21. So Saul said, I will give her to him that she might be a snare to him. The king Saul did not want to put his hand to David, but he wanted David to be killed from the Philistine. So he gave David his own daughter Micah as a wife for that to be a snare for David. That means there are other positions in life, all the things in life, all the relationship has been given to you as a snare. When they discover your breakthrough season, when they discover what God has put in you, when they discover that God is with you, when they discover your table is ready, when they discover what God is preparing for you, when they discover that the sound, your blowing sound, is going to be heard soon, so they will give you something as a snare. The king said, I will give him my daughter as a wife as a snare. Because when I give him my daughter as a wife, I will not ask him money. I will ask him the foreskin of the Philistine. So when he will go, the Philistine will kill him. So giving David his daughter as a wife was a snare. There are a lot of things, some of the position, some of the name, some of the relationship, some of the gift has been given to you as a snare because they discover your table is getting ready. So they want to steal your table, to steal your blessing. That's why they want to do a snare to you, to steal your blessing, to finish you. That is the plan of the enemy, according to John 10:10. The thief does not come except to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But that will not happen. That is why you need to behave wisely. In your breakthrough season, you need to behave even more wisely as David. David was behaving more wisely. That is why God used that character, that attitude to protect him, to save him. That is why the Bible says, be wise in the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 16. Be wise as the serpent. Even God is with you, please be wise as a David. That is why the Bible asks us to be wise. I know God is with you. That is why he's preparing a table for you. But you need to be wise as a David. God was with him, even his enemy. The Bible says the king Saul was David's enemy all his life. Why? Because he did understand God was with David. You need to behave wisely. Behave wisely in your breakthrough season. If you are married or single, the devil will send people to you for you to commit adultery or sexual immorality. In your breakthrough season, the devil will send women or men to come to you